Hey, Vowel community, Rolling Stones fans, classic rock fans, rock and roll fans in general. Today, I wanted to do what will hopefully be a brief video on my favorite rock and roll intro of all time. It's a song, Monkey Man, by the Rolling Stones. And interesting because it's not a guitar riff like Brown Sugar or Satisfaction. There's nothing very flashy about it. There's not some kind of, you know, sophisticated guitar solo or anything like that. It's just purely the mood that it establishes for this song and why I think it is so cool. So I want to break it down a little bit just to kind of plead my case why I am so in love with the intro to this song. So there's going to be some different pieces that we're going to want to pay attention to. And the intro is broken up into three sections. So the first section, which it starts off right out of the gate, you've got the tinkling piano. There's Bill Wyman on the bass, which it's not a terribly complicated riff. It's basically doon-doon-doon-doon. Doon, 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 doon. That's the first section right there. And then you've got this hum in the background. I'm not sure exactly what it is. Maybe some of you musicians out there who are in the know might be able to better articulate what this hum is. But I'm just going to play the very first section of it to give you an idea of what I'm paying attention to right here. So you got Bill Wyman, simple bass riff, boom, 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 which ends up being actually when the actual song starts. That's the guitar riff that you hear. Now the guitar is playing that riff, but you've got that hum in the background. Pay attention this time when I play it. I don't know, I'm getting carried away, but pay attention to kind of that hum in the background because that really kind of establishes almost like a menacing kind of a feel to this intro. So I'll start it back again. And that hum in the background, listen for that this time. Now it picks up here. So that's the first section. Then the second section, there's going to be a tambourine, which starts to carry the rhythm a little bit. And now Bill Wyman is going to be playing a different bass riff than he was playing for the first part of the intro. So listen how that bass riff is different from the boom, 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 boom. It's different now. Listen to it. He's mixing it up a little bit. It's getting a little bit more complicated. You still got the tinkling piano. And this time you've got the tambourine, which is going to carry through the second part of the intro. So the bass riff is different. He's mixing it up a little bit. There's just the slightest bit of rhythm guitar playing throughout it. It's very low, but it's there. And then you've got the tambourine, but you still got the tinkling piano. And then this is where Charlie Watts and the drums kick in. And then Bill Wyman in this third section of the intro just totally abandons kind of that little sophisticated bass riff that he had in that middle section. And it's just going to be kind of a regular bass riff there. But you're going to have Keith Richards coming in now with the rhythm guitar playing those power chords. And but now you got the rhythm, so it's totally in the space of just that little intro. Now we're kicking it into high gear. We're ready to launch the ship off into the stratosphere. So, Charlie Watts. So all Bill Wyman is playing is that's all he was playing. He's not doing any of the it's just strictly the kind of taking it down that descending path. You've got that kick-ass guitar riff playing there from Keith Richards. You've got Charlie Watts on the drums establishing that rhythm. It's just awesome. So let's listen to those three sections all together now from the beginning. And you've got, instead of the tinkling now, now you've got the keyboard. It's starting to play chords now. Instead of the tinkling now in that last section, now it's chords along with the guitar riff, the drums, Bill Wyman kind of guiding the bass, that descending bass there. I'm so sorry. I'm going to have to back it up again. But this, I'm telling you, I don't care. I can, you know, it's sort of like eating a cake. Like the icing is fantastic. Cake's all right. But like, damn it, like the best buttercream frosting you've ever had on a piece of cake. And then the rest of the cake is like, yeah, the cake's good, but it's all about the icing. And that's how it is with the song. So last time, I'm going to back it up. But just listen to, there's a lot of things to pay attention to. So for the first two pieces of the intro, you've got the tinkling piano, but then once those drums kicked in, now the piano is playing the chords. Bill Wyman simplifies it on the bass with kind of descending chords, and then Keith Richards just killing it on the guitar, and then of course you got Charlie Watts on the drums. So one last time, and then straight off into the song. All right. Well, you know the rest of the song anyway. The rest of the song is cool, but the piano, it plays such an integral part to the intro, and it's barely there like the rest of the song. It sets it up, and it's almost like the booster rockets on the space shuttle where it's like, okay, we've done our job. I mean, you do hear some piano, but not like as front and center as you hear in that intro. I believe it's Nicky Hopkins on the piano there, but just a fantastic freaking intro. And, you know, Rolling Stones, you think about all the great riffs that opened up their songs, all the, you know, memorable Keith Richards guitar licks and whatnot. But I submit to you, for my money, that is my favorite rock and roll intro. And I'm covering the Beach Boys, too. My favorite guitar song intro, I should say. My favorite song intro of all time. So comment as you wish, agree, disagree, but anyway, have a great day.